So first we'll talk about the topics that we discussed in our previous class, a report builder, and develop a simple report using wizard, right? And develop a master detail report using wizard, okay? And the agenda for today is develop a simple report manually, develop a master detail report manually. Okay, these two topics we will be discussing today. First let me explain this again briefly, okay, or quickly I'll show you again with the different examples. Okay, let's develop a simple report using this app. So what we have to do, we need to go to the report builder first. So when we open the report builder, it opens with three options using a report wizard: build a new report manually, and open an existing report. So we have to use the report wizard. When you are developing a report manually, you can choose this, or you can cancel it and you can start developing manually. Okay, let's use the report wizard. Click OK. So welcome to the report wizard. Click OK. Next, you need to choose create paper layout. Okay, click next. Let's take, for example, items report. Okay, so for simple report without any headings, etc., you can take this. You can take for any query, you can take any wizard. Okay, so for example, I am taking tabular report. Click next. SQL query. Click next. Here you can give, for example, select inventory, item ID, segment 1, description, okay, creation date, from MTL system items B. Inventory item ID, segment 1, description, creation date, MTL system, from MTL system. Click next. Okay, connect. So display all fields. If you want only few of them, then you can choose this, move it one by one. Otherwise you can click here, move all items to target. Okay, click next. Click next. So these are the labels. If you want to change, you can change here. Otherwise, just click next. This is the template. Okay, any template you can choose. Click next. Finish. So this is the output. You can just maximize it. Inventory item ID, segment 1, description, and creation date, items report. Okay, so this is to go to the next page. This is to go to the last page, bold, italic, underline. If you want to apply any currency, percentile, comma, etc., you can use them. And here you can fill the color, you can line the color, you can text color. Okay, close this. So this is the main menu. This is the report name. This, if you save, this will change. So you can go to the data model. Here you can see the query, or simply double click on data model to see your query. Okay, Q1, you can see the query. Cancel it. If you want to change it, you can change it. You can modify the query, otherwise cancel. And coming to the layout, paper layout, if you double click here, the layout will be displayed. So these are all the boilerplates, that means titles. You can click on any field. These are all the fields coming from the database. So example segment 1, close. Okay, so field segment 1 is there. These are the fields, and here you can see this header. HDR means that's header. So in the header you will see creation date, description, inventory, item ID, segment 1. Those are all nothing but headings. These are all coming from the table. Okay, so this is a simple report we developed. Now we'll close this and we'll create one more report. Close. You want to save the changes? No. Okay, you can click here directly. Again, it will ask you to create the report using wizard or create it manually. So let's take again using the wizard. Click OK. Next, choose create paper layout. Click next. So you can choose any of the option. If you are developing a complex query, for example, that we developed OU wise purchase orders, right? So OU wise PO. Example group left or group above, you can take. Click next. SQL query. Click next. Here we can write the query. First, you can write the query in the tone, then you can copy paste there. So select what is operating unit, HOU dot organization ID. HOU dot organization ID, that is name. ID and name, and we wanted to display PO header information, that is PO header ID, and PH dot segment one, that is PO number, PH dot type lookup code, and PH dot authorization status. Okay, from HR underscore operating underscore units HOU and PO underscore headers underscore all, that is PH, where PH dot RID equal to HOU dot organization ID. Click next. So the query is created successfully. Group fields. I want this organization ID and name as header, so I can take this. Click next. Group fields, displayed fields, take everything. Click next. Again next. If you want to change the headings, you can change here. For example, organization ID is there. I can write operating unit ID. Okay, so that you can understand easily. This is operating unit name. Header ID. This is nothing but PO header. And segment one. This is PO number. This is PO type. Like this, you can change. PO status. Width, if you want to increase, you can increase it. Click next. So template. Click next. Finish. Okay, output is displayed. Operating unit ID is 204. Operating unit name is this, and these are all the POs. Different POs with their type and status. So you can go to the page and you can check this. So this is a master data and this is child data. If you go to the last page, there are a lot many records, so we'll take time to reach the last page. Or you can break in between any page, break at next page, example. So in 204 itself, there are many records. Yeah, you can see different operating units and POs. Okay. 7905, 7932, 7933. With our operating units, and in that, these are all the purchase orders. Okay, so this is master detail report. Close this. Now you can see how it's created. The data model, first we have to go to the data model to look at the query. This is a query, and in this, we have taken these two fields as group fields, right? So this is a group. And with the first column name, it creates a group. Okay. And this is the second group, that is for the child detail. This is the second group. So it's separated. The report builder itself will separate those group columns and make a new group. Okay, close this. Close it. And headers, the header section, name and organization ID. And in that, again, you will have other columns like PO number, segment one, etc. These are the boilerplates of this details and all the fields here. And this is the boilerplate for headers and the fields. It's simple. This is the group, first group, master. Okay. And second one, details. So organization ID with organization ID, it's group. With PO header, it's group. So anyway, you need to just expand it and you can find the columns simply here. Headings and columns, headings, columns. If you look at the layout, if you go to the layout, you can see operating unit ID. And here, the column will be there. Organization ID, that's a column field coming from the table. Operating unit name, column will be there. That's a name, right? This is a field, if you see F underscore. If you observe closely, you can see that F underscore here, right? Somewhere F is there. Or double click here, you can see the field name here, F name. That is the operating unit name. Okay, organization ID. You can close also, you can close and see, it will highlight. Whatever you select, it will highlight here. If you go to the paper layout, for example, type lookup code, highlight it, close this. So we'll show the field, that's a type lookup code. Again, go to paper layout, choose the heading, PO type, close. It will show the heading, that's a type lookup code heading. So if you want to recompile and run the program, run the report always, you have to press Ctrl Shift K, then Ctrl Shift R. Ctrl Shift K is to compile the report, and Ctrl Shift R is to run the report, to show the output. Depends on the records, will take time. It will format the page and it will show the output. Okay, so fine. So this is what all about simple report and develop a master detail report using Wizard. Now we'll see how to develop a report manually. Okay, how to develop a report manually. First, let's start with a simple report, like showing items or showing users, etc. Very simple report we'll develop first. Okay, close this now. So click here, when you click here, again, it will ask you to show the report as like using the wizard. You want to develop a report using wizard or you want to develop a report manually. So let's take this, click OK. So when you choose the manual option, we'll open the report with the data model. Okay, the data model is open. Here you have to do this, or you can do it from here also. So the first step is what? We need to create the query. When the data model is open, or you have to open the data model. This is the very first step when you are creating a report manually. You want to create a report manually. That's our agenda, okay? This is the agenda. Develop a simple report manually. This is what I'm going to explain now. Okay, we discussed these two reports. Now I'm going to explain you how to develop a simple report manually. So what we have to do is you need to go to the data model first and create the query. This SQL query is there, right? Click here and click here. Start developing the query here. Example, okay, inventory, item, ID, segment one, description, from MTL system items B. Okay, I'm taking from this. Click OK. So query has created. This is how the query creates. Item ID is created, segment one and description is created. Close this. So you can see here the fields. After this, we have to go to paper layout. Okay, first the query part has to be completed, and we have to make sure the query is working fine. Otherwise, it won't create. Now we have to go to paper layout. In the paper layout, what we have to do is, first thing is, very first step is, you need to create a frame that's called repeating frame. Okay, first we have to create a repeating frame like this. After the frame is created, you need to create fields inside this. Fields, whatever the fields that you selected in the select statement, for them we have to create fields. First thing is repeating frame. I'll show you why this is required. So, but you need to create the repeating frame. After the repeating frame is created, create fields inside this. The fields are, you have to take from here. So the field for inventory item ID. Okay, we have selected inventory item ID, right? So we'll take this. Again, click here. Segment one, that is item name. Description. Okay, so there are total three columns we have. Now what we have to do is, if you go back to the menu, you will see the paper layout, this R1, that's a repeating frame. F1, F2, F3, these are the fields. Okay, the fields which we created, right? These are F1, F2, F3. Now, this R1, we have to link this. The group is created, right, in the data model. You open the data model, this group is created. This, we have to link to here, to here. And all the fields we need to link to these columns. Like this is, for example, if it's an inventory item ID, then you need to link this. And this is segment one, this we need to link. Okay, so this is the order basically. Here, whatever the order is there, that doesn't matter. This is the order, how you want. For example, if you want the item ID first, then we have to join this. Inventory item ID, we have to attach to this segment one and description. Okay, in the paper layout. So this is a repeating frame. For this repeating frame, if you open double click, this is a repeating frame. See, R1 will highlight, right? If you close here, go back to a field, see F2 is highlighted. But now there is no relation between this, between data model and paper layout. So output won't come. So to show the output, what we have to do, this has to be linked to this. What we have to do is here, you can choose the repeating frame here. Go to property, right click. Okay, with your mouse, right click. Go to property inspector. In the property inspector, you have source, right? This source, you need to link. The G inventory item ID, the record group which we are seeing, right? That we have to join here. We have to attach. Close this. That is for the repeating frame. Now go to field. Right click, go to property inspector, attach the source. Here it will show all the fields. Like what's your field? Inventory item ID, right? Somewhere you will find the inventory item ID. Close this. Again, click here, right click, go to property inspector. You can see the segment one. Okay, close this. Again, right click, go to property inspector, description. You can also see description. If you want some page numbers, etc., you can, for example, here I wanted to see the page number and date. Okay, so you can also create fields here outside the frame, because page numbers should not repeat for each and every record, right? So you can click here. Can take and right click. This is the page. Go to property inspector. You can choose the standard. This is the like a predefined columns, current date, Current date is for what? Date. Page number. If you want to see the page number, you can choose the page number. You can click here. Close this. Okay, page number is there and fields are there. You can write text also here. Like here, for example, I want to write here. You can write text. Page number. And here also you want headings. Then you can click here and type. This is what? Item ID. This is the item name. This is description. Okay. And you want another heading, you can click here. For example, inventory items report. You can click here, bold, you can put, underline, you can put, if any color you want to put, you can increase the size, you can put those things. Okay, so now after this, what we did, we created a repeating frame first and we attached that. We created fields and we attached source and we also operate some headings. Now this you need to reduce the size, otherwise this much big you will see in the output. So let's join this here. Whatever the space you have, right, that space will come here. So it all depends on the output, how it is coming and how you want that you can. And here, if any fields you are moving down up, the entire frame is also moving, right? So if you don't want to move the frame, here we have two options, flex on, flex off. So you take flex on, okay, flex on and try. Okay, it's moving. Click here, flex off. Now see, only it won't come outside. And it's flexible, so you can move easily. It won't disturb the frame. But if you click here, flex on, the entire frame is disturbed. So that's why better you take flex off. These two are confine off, confine on. This is basically, if you click this, right, your label, that field can come outside. If you want to lock it, it will be locked. So it won't come outside. I'm trying to press down arrow, but it will stop here. It won't come out. So it's better to confine on, okay? Because any database field which should be inside the frame, by mistake, accidentally, if you don't want to go outside, so then it's better to confine on. And whenever you are doing something and should be more flexible, then you can get flex off. And this is the space, right? This is the space which will come each in between each record. So better to touch like this. Okay. So finally your report should look like this, the frame. So now the report is ready. Let's run this report. Control Shift K to compile the report always, and Control Shift R to run the report. Okay, output is displayed. So you can apply on this again, you can apply pages, colors, everything you can apply here. Fill color or no fill, lines, no line, text color, all those things are applicable. So here, if you go to the next page, these headings are there, right? These headings. These headings won't repeat in all the pages. So it's not repeating. So what we have to do is, for that, can close this. Okay, this is the new thing again. I mean, this is the query, and these are the fields that we created, titles, and these are the fields. Okay, so go to paper layout again. You select, hold the shift key, press shift and hold it, select other columns, all the headings you select, the headings that you want to repeat in all the pages. Okay, then press F4. F4 is nothing but it's a property inspector. You can press F4 also, or you can go to property inspector manually. Print object on all pages. If you want it only first page, you can choose this. Last page, you can choose this. All but first page, you can choose this. Okay. So default means only first page. So you choose all pages. Close this. Okay. Let's compile this report again. Okay. Output, page number, item ID. You can adjust here also directly. In the output window also, you can adjust. So click here. So it's repeating now, right? If you want to put date, any other things, you can do it. So this is how we develop report manually. Questions or doubts? Okay, I'll repeat the steps again. First step, when you want to develop a simple report manually, okay, what we have to do? After the report builder is open, choose the manual option. It will open the data model window, or you can double click here. This is the data model window. So what we did, we have selected SQL, right? So SQL, click here. The window is created. Here you can create your query. That's how we did, right? That's how we did for this. Then this Q1 has created, and these are the columns. Inventory item ID is there. Segment one is there, description is there from the table. Close this. Nothing to do now here. After this Q1 is created, I mean query is created, close this. Okay, you will see all the columns here. This is the group. The group has created, right? The data model itself, you can see this is a group. And after that, what we have to do? We need to go to the paper layout. Okay, after the query is created, go to paper layout. Here, the first step is what? Repeating frame we have to do, right? This is a repeating frame. This is a repeating frame. And inside this, we have created fields for based on our output or requirement. You can create fields. This repeating frame attached with, go to property inspector and attach the group that we created in the data model that we have to attach as source. Okay, close this. And for every field, we have to attach the source. Inventory item ID. Similarly, for segment one, description. Titles, if you want to put any titles, you have to choose this. And this is the heading we have created. And if you want to print these headings in every page, choose the property inspector. That print object on all pages. Okay, so you can refer this. I'll save it. This is very, very important. Basic information, but it's very important. And it helps you to understand other reports quickly and easily. Okay, so now I'll close this. Let's see how to create a master detail report. Okay, for example, we'll see invoices information based on operating unit. Operating unit wise invoices. So first we'll prepare the query. What is the invoice table? Select stars from AP invoices R. Right, this is the invoice table. So you'll have invoice ID, invoice number you'll have, and somewhere you will have invoice amount. I want these three. Okay. Yeah, including currency also will take. Vendor ID also important. But vendor ID will take vendor name. Instead of vendor ID, will take vendor name. So for that, what we have to do? Master detail. The org ID, organization also.